Let's solve 2 to the 3x plus 4 equals 5. So let's solve this equation. This is an equation because of the equal sign there. We're going to need the definition of logarithm. So this will turn into 3x plus 4 equals log base 2 of 5. Now, we've done the hard step. The rest is not so bad. Remember that log base 2 of 5 is just a number. So on the right side here, this is just 2 to the what equals 5. Not that we need to answer that question, because that number isn't so nice. It's some decimal, but the point is log base 2 of 5 is just a number. That's the thing to keep in mind. So when solving this equation, 3x plus 4 equals this number, think of what you do if you were to solve 3x plus 4 is equal to 100. I'll subtract 4 on both sides. It's just, this won't simplify any further. So we just write log base 2 of 5 minus 4. Okay, that's fine. Just leave it like that. There's no point doing any calculator work here. And then just divide both sides by 3. So you have x is equal to log base 2 of 5 minus 4 all over 3. By the way, you can rewrite the answer as this log base 2 of 5 part can be rewritten ln of 5 over ln of 2 using the change of base formula. Both of these are acceptable answers. If you're just doing something on paper, probably just this answer. X is equal to log base 2 of 5 minus 4 over 3. But if you want, you can also write x is equal to ln of 5 over ln of 2 minus a 4 all over 3. Now, let's solve the equation 2 to the power 3x plus 4 equals 5 to the x, which looks very similar to the equation that we just solved. You'll notice that the only difference between the equation we just solved and the equation that we're about to solve is, on the right side, it's not just a 5 anymore, but it's 5 to the x power. The thing is, in the last problem, it was super convenient to use the definition of logarithm because we just had a constant on one side. Now, that's not going to work out so well. Right? Because of the exponent on the right side as well, there's this to the x power. We won't apply the definition of logarithm like we just did. We're going to do something else. So take this equation, right? The only difference from the previous slide is the start of the question has not just a 5 on the right side, but now a 5 to the x power. Definition of logarithm won't really be that helpful here, so instead we're going to do something quite a lot messier. We're going to apply ln to both sides. We're going to take the natural logarithm of the left side and the natural logarithm of the right side. So ln of 2 to the power 3x plus 4 equals ln of 5 to the x. Now take each side separately and apply the third law of logarithms. We'll have 3x plus 4 quantity times ln of 2 equals x times ln of 5. Now keep in mind that ln of 2 is a number, right? So we can distribute ln of 2. I'm not distributing ln. That would be a mistake. And we don't need to. There's no distributing ln. There's just distributing the number ln of 2. Again, keeping track of what really happens here is helpful. You got to really know what's going on. And so ln of 2, remember, is just log base e of 2. In other words, e to the what equals 2. Now, that's just some number. I'm not saying we need to answer that question, but just even phrasing the question helps us go, oh, yeah, ln of 2 is just a number. So we distribute ln of 2, not ln. We can't distribute ln. That's not what we're doing. We distribute ln of 2. So we have 3 times x times ln of 2 plus 4 times ln of 2 equals x times ln of 5. Now let's get all the terms that have x on one side. Yeah, so how about we subtract x ln 5 on both sides, subtract 4 ln of 2 on both sides, and so the left side has all the terms with x, the right side has all the terms without x, and so why do that? Because now we can factor out x. The left side is rewritten just by writing x times the quantity, 3 times ln of 2 minus ln of 5. The right side, nothing happened there. We didn't do something to both sides, so the right side is still just a negative 4 times ln of 2. Now, look what happened. We went from the previous equation where x was written twice to this new equation where x is only written once, and we've got x times this stuff, all this in parentheses. I'd like you to recognize that as being a number. We just need to divide both sides by that number. So we'll have x equals the fraction negative 4 times ln of 2 all over 3 times ln of 2 minus ln of 5, and we're done. Now, let's solve the equation 2 to the 3x plus 4 equals 64 to the x. This looks very similar to what we did here. All that's different about the question now is instead of a 5 to the x, it's a 64 to the x. So the 5 changed to 64. New problem, looks very similar. Unlike the question we just answered, we don't have to take ln of both sides. We could if we want. The work would look about this messy. There's something faster that we can do instead. And the whole reason we can do something faster is because the base is 64 instead of a base being 5. 2 and 5 don't really share anything in common, but the point is 64 Well, check this out. 64 can be replaced with 2 to the 6th. So this is valid. We replaced the 64 with 2 to the 6th. A common mistake is to try to replace 2 with 2 to the 6th. If you replace 2 with 2 to the 6th, you have a problem because, well, 2 and 2 to the 6th are different numbers, right? So that would change the problem. But you can change 64 with a 2 to the 6th power because, well, 64 equals 2 to the 6th. There's still this to the x to write. And then, well, the right side, 2 to the 6th quantity to the x can be rewritten 2 to the 6 times x using the formula a to the m to the n is equal to a to the m times n. Now that both the left and the right side are 2 to the something, yeah, the left side is 2 to an exponent, the right side is 2 to an exponent with a matching base, no slashes through the 2s, we can set the exponents equal. And we have 3x plus 4 is equal to 6x. Now we have a fairly nice equation to solve. Maybe subtract 3x on both sides. We'll keep the x's on the right side here just to avoid writing so many minus signs. So 4 is equal to 3x, divide both sides by 3. Oops, that should say just an x there. I'll fix that. Okay, let's just fix that right now. There we go. That's fixed. Sorry about the error. So dividing by 3 on both sides, we have 4/3 is equal to x. And we're done. So what's the point comparing this to the previous question that we did here where we ln both sides? This I hope you can see empirically, takes more writing than this answer right here. Right? This is a much shorter answer. So I think the point here is to say don't just ln both sides just because you can. I mean, think strategically. Think about what you can do to save time. So if the bases seem related, then rewrite bases like we did here. 64 was rewritten as 2 to the 6. And then use this formula. Use this old exponent formula. In fact, it's good to not have one way to do things. It's good to know of 2 or 3 or 4 ways to do a problem if there are, in fact, 2 ways or 3 ways or 4 ways to do a problem. And among those, to pick something that is fastest. And actually, not only that, in this case, not only is this faster, it's good. It's really good to start practicing and reviewing things that happened early on in the semester. So that's, I think, why this is preferable. Okay, and if the bases don't seem related, like the one we did earlier, where instead of a 64 as a base, there was a 5 as a base, then you ln both sides and use the third law of logarithms.